it's hard to let go of the people we love. It's hard, especially when their loss is sudden. So many of us here are shocked to lose Carol. I know Lynn and Karen were aware she had health concerns, but she'd been through so many close calls over the years. It just seemed like she'd be able to come through this one too. But our bodies have limits. Carol just didn't have the resources left to fight this last battle. Still, Carol was a rock. She was that for her family and for her friends. She had no idea how many lives she touched and influenced here at North and in our community. Karen and Lynn told me the other day that Carol was active in every area of their lives. She was a room mother at school. She led Girl Scouts. She volunteered in all sorts of organizations. She was involved in every aspect of life here at North as a deacon, an elder, a caregiver, a good friend. Most of us don't have a lot of people in our lives who are like that. And we were sure blessed to have Carol. But there was more to her than just volunteering and helping out. Carol was an RN, very professional. She always had a thing or two to say about the care she received. She spent part of her career training adults to be home health care aides in our community. So her reach was really pretty long, affecting a lot of people in our area and beyond. She had a way of relating to people that put them at ease, made them laugh. She loved going to the urban diner, part of Friends of Night people, to serve meals and visit with folks who ate there. One story she shared with us was of a man who came to the diner and kept to himself. As he checked in, Carol said, "Have a nice dinner." And after he was finished and leaving, she said, "Have a nice evening." He turned and he gave her sort of an odd look and said, "Thanks for telling me to have a nice evening. I know you mean it." She said she did. As he left, he gave her a wave and said, "See you next month." Well, a social worker standing nearby asked her, "How did you get that man to talk to you? He doesn't talk to anyone." She said, "Well, God helped her." And he agreed. I don't think God just helped Carol. I think God was working through her. She became the presence of God for that man, just as she did for so many others when she would offer some advice or a dinner or some wonderful cookies, or just make us laugh. And Carol was a terrific leader here at North, but I'm not sure she was all that comfortable in the role. She liked the nitty-gritty of things. She wanted to do for people. That's why Karen and Lynn chose that passage from Matthew's gospel for today. It's not a common scripture reading at a funeral. It's a little intimidating since it's talking about final judgment. But it's a great image of how Carol approached the world. She was that person, the one who fed and clothed and visited, even to some in prison. And she didn't do those things out of fear of judgment, but because they needed doing and she was here. That's why we'll be singing, "Here I Am, Lord," at the end of our service. Think of it as Carol's anthem. When God called, she responded. A few years ago, I was a little worried about Carol when she lost the love of her life, Bob. The two of them were inseparable. They used to attend our early morning worship service in the chapel on Sundays at 8:30. After he died, though, she just couldn't bring herself to come to that service without him. And that's a hard adjustment to make. Sometimes folks can't even get themselves to come back to church at all when they're grieving. But she did come to the later service here in the sanctuary, and she pushed herself to do more with the time she had. She made the adjustment to life without Bob with such grace and compassion. It was an inspiration to those of us who knew how hard it was for her. But there was never any bitterness in Carol. Never any regret. She made the most of all her opportunities and said the things she needed to say to the people around her. And she sure loved everyone around her. She always had a great story to tell about her beautiful grandchildren, Gina, Laura, and Harrison. And she was so proud of her daughters and their husbands, Nunzio and Matthew. And she really loved being part of such a wonderful, diverse family. She would tell me about the big gatherings with the Pellegras at Christmas or Easter and the delicious shout-up and Passover meals with the Kaufmans. It meant the world to her to be a part of your families. And I know how much you all will miss her. Losing someone like Carol is hard, and there is no easy way to go through this. It will take time to let her go, to really say goodbye. And that's okay. You can hang on to her for a while longer. You need to live with your grief, to dwell in the valley for a while. The Jewish custom of sitting Shiva, spending 7 days in mourning with family and friends when a loved one dies, is something we Christians can learn from. We have this tendency to speed through grief because we put our trust in the resurrection. Our faith tells us death is overcome in the risen Christ, which is a wonderful source of hope and comfort. But grief is real and shouldn't be ignored. Because in the weeks and months ahead, grief will catch up to you. You may find yourself feeling sad all of a sudden without really knowing why. Chances are something reminds you of Carol. Or it's a special day like her birthday or their anniversary. You might not even have been conscious of it, but the sadness will be there. Don't ignore that. Share it with someone. Let the people close to you know what's going on and tell some stories about Carol so you can laugh and cry together. Carol was able to be God's presence for others because she was surrounded by so much love. She was surrounded by all of you. It's through these relationships of love that God is present in the world. So hold on to each other. Find strength in each other for the days ahead. And put your trust in the God who called Carol all her life and walked with her to walk with you, to lead you through this time of sadness, and bring you in time out of this valley to a high